Hey, how are you? Geez, good to see you.
Yeah.
Golly, Vince, I'm a little busy right now, so maybe you can come back later. What do you say?
Well, look, I don't understand, man. I talked to your manager yesterday. What's his name? Dogbite, that's it. And set this up.
Geez, Dogbite. You can't trust him as far as you can throw him. Geez, the guy's too strung out. He didn't tell me anything about it. Next time you want to see me, come make an appointment with me. Okay,
so hey, here I am. I'm right here. Let's talk.
Geez, bud. It's like 9 a.m.
On a Saturday.
On
a don't give me your sob story. I've been up since 5 o'clock. Early edition deadline's an hour and a half. I gotta make it with the story, Marshall.
All right. This won't take very long, will it?
No, I shouldn't. I don't need to fill up about 7 inches. Not that important, you know?
So what can I tell you, dude? I'm here to tear up the town. I like tearing up this town.
Yeah, but Marshall, I mean, nobody expected you to ever come back to Emerald City. I mean, you know, not after the Neon Lobsters went platinum back in 82. Randy Marshall, alias Marshall Stack, drops out of South Emerald City High School, hitchhikes to L.A. and becomes a big rock and roll stud to everyone's amazement. And now you're back, and living in this dump. What, are you broke now? I'd like to know how that happened, although I think I could probably figure it out if I thought about it real hard.
Jeez, Vince, how come I get the feeling this isn't going to be the most objective story you've ever written?
Okay, I know. I apologize. I'm coming down on you pretty hard, Randy. Marshall. I promised myself I'd let bygones be bygones.
Look, Vince, I know you don't like me, and I know why you don't like me. It's been 7 years since that fateful afternoon that I made the drastic mistake of being asked out to the burger bin with Angela D. Watkins, and I stole her away from you like the true little panty waste I am, right? And you're going to crucify me for that for the rest of me. What could I do? I mean, there she was, this voluptuous little thing with her hands all over me, grinding up against me, telling me she wants to go to bed with me. Well, what would you expect me to do? I suppose you would have walked away, right, pal?
Well, no, not necessarily.
Oh, sure you would have, but that's what you always seem to imply. You're Mr. Holier Than Thou. You always have been. The good kid. The kid who played the game. The kid who was too afraid to have any fun. Hell, you should blame yourself more than you should blame me. You were too damn boring. Too serious. Angela liked me because I was exciting, because I wasn't afraid to live on the edge.
Marshall, I loved Angela. I loved her like you'll never know. She was my everything. My entire existence was based on her. And she never really had a chance to find out what we could have meant to each other, did she? Did she? No, because you let her drive away from that party with Davey Taiwanon Andrews.
Now you're blaming me for her death? This is some way to renew our friendship, pal. I'm not the one that drove off the embankment and killed her.
No, but you could have prevented it.
I couldn't have done anything, pal.
Because you were on the couch, drunk and stoned out of your mind.
Angela Watkins is dead, man. She's been dead for 7 years, damn it, Vince. And there's nothing I can say or do that's going to bring her back. Just put it behind you for once and for all and make peace with me, not to mention yourself. So we can get on with the rest of our lives. Look, Vince, what do you say we just forget about the past and try and be friends, all right?
Okay, Marshall.
You can call me Randy.
I guess you're right. I do need to make peace with you. I need to make peace with myself.
Before you die?
Wait a minute. I didn't tell you I was dying yet, did I?
Lance did yesterday. He's worried about you and he thought maybe I could help you. Show you some good times. Help you shift gears. Move into the fast lane, huh? Might as well go out in style, right?
But I don't see how you can help me, Randy. I mean, sometimes I wonder if I'm really going to last that long anyway. And besides, I mean, how could I possibly enjoy life more than I'm enjoying it right now?
Vince, take that damn notepad out of your hands, quit your job, and start hanging around with me, dude. I owe you one anyway, right? You stick with me, and we'll have so much fun you'll forget about the fact that you're dying.
I don't know, Randy. I mean, you know, what could possibly make the last year of my life so exciting?
Three simple words, man. Sex, drugs, and rock and roll.
Marshall, where'd you get this shirt? I love it. How does it look on me?
Natalie!
Vince?
Natalie!
Vince?
Natalie!
Vince?
Natalie! Natalie!
Vince? Vince?
Natalie, what are you doing here? Wait a minute, I think it's rather obvious what you're doing here. You've done it to me again, haven't you, Randy? You've done it to me again! It's the one story I can't wait to write, mister. Bye, Natalie.
That's just great. I didn't know he was here. I didn't even know you knew Vince.
I'm sorry, I didn't even know you were involved with him.
Well, I'm not. Not anymore. It's just that it hasn't been very long since we broke up, and I don't want to hurt Vince, or, you know, any more than I already have. He didn't want us to split up, but I just couldn't take it anymore.
Jeez, it must have been especially hard since he's dying.
What?
I said it must have been especially hard since he's dying.
He's what? He's going to die? Vince is dying? Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, God. God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, God. Oh, God.